an MRI scanner is one. It's an imaging modality that we can use in radiology departments. MRI stands for magnetic resonance imaging, and basically it's a very large magnet. It looks a little bit, it looks similar to a CT scanner, but it's a little bit longer. It's also a little bit, a bit of a smaller aperture to go into for the body as well. Basically what we're looking at the hydrogen atoms in the body. We also use, as well as the magnets, we use some radio frequency pulses. And it's characterised by very loud noise, which is a banging noise, has different frequencies of noise and different different types of noise depending on what sequences we're actually running in the scan and what images we're trying to collect. As far as the patient's concerned, it is a little bit tight in the scanner if you're a particularly large patient. Your doctor should refer you only if you will fit into the scanners. It does depend on your build, etc. It depends on the widest part of you as you're laying down. So the scanner that we have here at the Wilson Brain Imaging Centre, and the majority of MRI scanners, have a 60 centimetre diameter bore, so that's the aperture that you move through. So if you're wider than 60 centimetre diameter at your largest part, which is usually either the hips or the abdomen, then you may have difficulties in fitting. But most departments would welcome visits for you to come and have a try, and don't worry about these things. We can always, if we get you in, we'll absolutely get you out of a scanner. So we would never put you in there if you don't want to be in there equally. You know, both for clinical and for research purposes, we do care about how you perceive a scan, so we'll make sure that you're happy when you're in there. Preparation wise, I would make sure that you have certainly been to the bathroom before you have a scan, and make sure that you remove all your jewellery and leave it at home. There's nothing worse than somebody turning up and having lots of jewellery that they then have to remove we do have some lockers available, but you know, it does take time sometimes to remove lots of jewellery, and particularly some modern jewellery where they're actually put in by the jewellers, and they may need you know, pliers, etc., to remove them. We do have pliers, but we don't want to damage anybody. So making sure that you're safe to go in the scanner. If you can wear clothes with minimal amounts of metal on, that's also very helpful whilst you have your scan. As far as research goes, I actually would choose not to scan somebody that's claustrophobic, because it can be detrimental to the scans that we're doing. But having said that, some of the scans that we do, of course, are for clinical imaging. And it's in the patient's best interest to have the scan done, and we'll do everything we can to make sure that they are comfortable and to make sure that the patient is happy in the scanner. We can have a mirror on top of the scanner so you can see out. We can play movies. We can play music. We can provide an eye mask if it's really intolerable. And if the scan is required clinically and there's no other way of imaging, then there's always the option for the patient to speak to their clinician and have a little bit of medication that will help them to get through the scan. But normally I would always advise that, you know, the radiographers are very skilled at putting patients in scanners, and we know how to calm them down. There's all, you know, it's good time well spent to make sure that you have your scan nicely. Essential to let us know if you think beforehand that you're going to struggle, if you've had problems before. Yes, please let the referring clinician know before you attend. So some scans that we do, we need to do an injection to administer a contrast medium. That's a gadolinium, which is a metal type of substance that we inject into the patient. That's used to highlight any areas that we may have difficulty in diagnosing. Certainly we can look at the difference between organic matters, etc., in the areas of interest. So it would highlight all the vessels and would then highlight any area of his interest that are in the brain. There are minimal side effects. Obviously we would always check for any allergies, but with the gadolinium there are minimal side effects. It's not like a CT contrast where you may feel warm or flushed, or if you have an allergy to shellfish or anything. So we do check the creatinine levels, however, of all patients to make sure that they are well cared for beforehand. The best thing to do, in my opinion, to keep calm is just is breathing, and to remember to breathe. Patients, if they sometimes patients don't know they're claustrophobic. I think that's the issue. And they'll get into a scanner and they'll suddenly realise that they've got a cough, or they'll be wanting a drink, or they'll want to start stripping off. And these are all signs of mild claustrophobia, and we recognise that. So there's a way of speaking to patients when you're in the scanner, and just a calming hand on their shoulder, actually, just to lower the shoulders and just to get them to breathe in and out a few times will just calm them down. If we're really worried, we'll put a pulse oximeter on and we can always check to make sure they're all right. We do need to keep making sure that we do speak to them. We have an intercom that we can speak to patients. So keeping communications open is sometimes the best way to keep people reassured once they're in the scanner, and that works quite well. The other option is that if it's not for research, if it's for pure clinical reasons, if there is a relative or an accompanying person that is safe to go in the scanner, they're always welcome to go in and handhold if possible. So that might be the way that they get through a scan. I'm equally happy to look at that. That's a very good question. So as a radiographer, obviously we are not the reporting clinician. We have a very good idea of what we're looking at on the scans, obviously, and with those the radiographers that are more experienced, you know full well what you're looking at. Having said that, though, the images still must be reviewed by a consultant radiologist. It is not up to the radiographer to give the information. However, if there happens to be a clinician around and they have already seen the images, then a discussion can be held with the clinician. But certainly not with the radiographer. We would give them advice. Feedback would be, you did very well, the images are lovely, you kept beautifully still. They'll now be sent off for reporting. It's not within our remit to show images, unfortunately. Thank you very much for coming to your scan today. So I'm just going to go through and make sure that you're safe to go in the scanner. So as you know, this is an MRI scanner. It's a very large magnet, so we need to ensure that we don't take anything that we shouldn't take into the room, or any loose metallic parts, etc. So I can see from your screening form that you're safe to go in our scanner, with the exception of your glasses, which we'll take off in just a moment. I'm just going to use a metal detector just to make sure that there's nothing that we have missed together, and then we'll take you into the scan room. So we'll just take your glasses off and we'll pop you in the scanner room. Okay, so as you approach the bed, if you just want to sit down in the middle of the couch, lay down on your back with your head in the frame at the top. Just be careful as you lay down, it's a bit hard at the back, don't hit your shoulders. Make sure that you're nice and comfortable. I'm going to pop a cushion underneath your knees. Are you feeling comfortable already? Okay, good. So the scanner's very noisy, sounds a little bit like a pneumatic drill at the roadside. So for that reason, we're going to pop you some earplugs in. It'll make sure it protects your hearing whilst you're in the scanner. I'm also going to put some cushions next to your head, and these are going to help to keep you still whilst you're in the scanner as well. Just coming into your hand now, there is an alarm bell. If you have any problems whilst you're in the scanner at all, just squeeze that buzzer and we can always stop the scan and speak to you, make sure that you're happy, or indeed we can stop the scan early and bring you out. I'm sure you'll be absolutely fine, it's just so you know that you've got control. So making sure that you're nice and comfortable now, I'm just going to put the head cushions on and put the top of the coil on, and we're going to drive you into the magnet now. Are you feeling all right?
Yes.
Happy to go ahead?
Yes.
Fantastic. So the table's going to move slowly into the magnet. Okay, so you're now at the right position. Are you happy to start?
Yes.
Fantastic. I'm just going to close the door and I'll go and start scanning now. You'll hear some loud scan noises coming. Just checking you can hear me over the intercom. Everything all right?
Yes.
The first scan is now starting. Loud burst of noise heading your way. You're doing really well. Keep going. Fantastic. We're all finished. We're going to bring you out now. Just keep nice and still while I bring the table out and bring you back down to the floor level. Well done, all finished.